A very good evening to all my dear students. I am Mrs. Parvati, PGT Physics, Holy Hearts Educational Academy, Raipur, Chhattisgarh. Today I am before you with a new topic that is energy stored in a parallel plate capacitor. We have done that is half CV square. Today we are going to also we have done the two charged bodies you take and join with them with the help of a conducting wire. There is a sharing of charges and also common potential exists, that also we have studied. So this class, whenever two charged bodies are joined together with a conducting wire, there is always loss of energy. That we are going to prove it mathematically. Then after that we will discuss with the practical example, natural example, right? So today's heading is loss of energy when two charged bodies are connected with the help of a connecting wire, that is conducting wire. So for that, take two charged body A having charge Q1 and potential V1 and then capacitance C1, and also charged body B, Q1, C1, V1 or Q2, C2, V2 are the charge, capacitance and potential of the second body, body B. 1 and 2 also you can take, no problem. And these are earth, two bodies we have done. And they have connected. They are not earthed, just they are mounted on a stand. And before joining them, you know energy stored here is half C1 V1 square and here half C2 V2 square, right? Then when you connect with the help of a connecting wire, it reaches, the charge flows from higher potential to lower potential. Here we are taking V1 is greater than V2 here. Then the charge flows from higher potential to lower potential, that is A to B, till both the bodies reach the common potential, that is V. V is the common potential. We know the expression for V, that is Q1 C1 upon Q1 C1, that Q1 plus Q2 upon C1 plus C2, that is Q1 is equal to C1 V1 plus C2 V2 upon C1 plus C2 we have done yesterday. Okay, so we will use common potential formula now. The common potential is C1 V1 plus C2 V2 upon C1 plus C2. That we are going to use it now because we have already done this common potential. Okay, then what is the energy after connection? You know that here charge is shared. So what is the energy of E1 before connection? Half C1 V1 square, just now I said. And what is energy on B, E2 is equal to half C2 V2 square. Then what is the total energy before connection? That is E1 plus E2, half C1 V1 square plus half C2 V2 square. Okay. Then after connection, what will happen? E1 is equal to half C1 V square because V is the common potential and E2 dash is given by E1 dash is after connection of capacitor, of the charged body A energy, and E2 is the second body, half C2 V square here. Add up these two, we will get the answer, half C1 plus C2 into V square we are getting here. See here. Let us substitute the value of V from our equation. We have already derived the common potential, C1 V1 plus C2 V2 upon C1 plus C2 here. This formula we will apply here. So substituting this formula here, the loss of energy means first final energy minus initial energy. Final energy minus initial energy. So always loss of energy is, I am telling loss of energy. What does it mean, loss of energy? Initially there is a lot of energy, then finally after connecting some energy is lost. So how do we calculate? We take initial energy minus final energy. Once again I repeat, when the two charged bodies are connected together, there is a loss of energy. Means the after connection some energy is lost. So final energy is greater than initial energy. Is it correct? No. The initial energy is greater than final energy. So we are subtracting the final energy from initial energy. So E minus E dash we are calculating here. E minus E dash you take here and add up and minus of this C1, C2 gets cancelled. C1 plus C2 denominator cancel. Take the average here. That is common you take 1 upon 2 into C1 plus C2 we will get here. Then if you simplify that, you will get the answer C1 C2 upon C1 plus C2 into V1 minus V2 whole square. This simplification is very easy, children. Just simply you have to remove the brackets and A minus B whole square, A plus B whole square formula you apply and then with the negative sign you multiply whatever it has come and cancel the like terms and then you will get the answer C1 C2 upon 2 into C1 plus C2 in numerator V1 minus V2 whole square. So here I would like to discuss, here I have taken V1 is greater than V2. Suppose if V2 is greater than V2, then also there is a loss of energy because V1 minus V2 whole square. So even though V1 is greater or V2 is greater, the negative something whole square become positive. So there is always loss of energy. The practical example, natural example I would like to tell you, whenever two charged bodies are connected together, there is a loss of energy. You know, whenever the thunderstorm takes place, first the lightning comes, then the thunder we will listen, right? What is thunder meaning? Sound energy. Lightning means lighting, light energy is released. When two charged bodies, where are they? Clouds. Clouds are charged particles, nothing but. When the two clouds are friction together, they join together, then what happens here? Due to the friction, they collide with each other, there is always loss of energy in the form of heat and light. Heat means very high energy is released, but here in this case here light energy is released in the form of lightning and sound energy is also released due to the loss of energy. So two charged bodies are clouds. When the clouds are joined together, coming closer to each other and then rubbing to each other, there is always loss of energy in the form of light energy and sound energy here. This is one of the good example for our loss of energy topic here for the two charged bodies connected to each other. It's clear? So next, what do you mean by energy density? Energy density of a parallel capacitor is defined as energy stored per unit volume of capacitor. Energy stored per unit volume of capacitor is called energy density of parallel plate capacitor. It is very important question. Definitely, it will come in your board examination. Okay. So, define energy density, find the expression for it. Energy. What is energy stored? We know that half CV square. You know that? Half CV square, you know that here. Okay. What is energy density? Energy per unit volume. Volume means area into distance between two parallel plates of capacitor. So, half CV square upon AD. What is the value of C of parallel plate capacitor? Epsilon naught A by D upon AD into V square. We know the relation between V is equal to ED, right? In place of V, substitute E into D. Then we get the formula, energy density is equal to half into epsilon naught A by D into E square D square upon D. So, AD, no? So, that is the area, volume. What is volume? Area into thickness. That is area into distance. That is volume into D here. So, this D square and D square gets cancelled here. And A also gets cancelled. So, what is left here? Half epsilon naught E square. So, the energy stored in a parallel plate capacitor per unit volume is half into epsilon naught E square, where E is electric field intensity, epsilon naught is electrical permittivity of air or free space here. Here nothing is there. Simply you take half CV square, C value substitute and put V is equal to, C is equal to epsilon naught A by D. You know it. And you know the relation between V and E. right? What is V? V is equal to E into D substitute, and you will get the formula half into epsilon naught into E square. So based on this loss of energy and energy density problems you solve, children, see you, bye bye.